the camera's rolling, your heart pounds. It's thrilling to me.
Toughest opponents throughout your career?
Toughest opponents, man. The toughest guys that were for me to guard were guys like Ray Allen, Reggie Miller.
They moved a lot.
Rip Hamilton. It was too much for me, man. Chasing off them picks, they never stopped moving.
I hated it.
See, people, man, listen, that is, because look, you got to spend so much energy defensively, it take away your offense because you're chasing the whole game. That's the hardest part.
Right.
That was them the hardest legs. People to guard. Yeah, people think, like, don't get me wrong, it is hard to guard Kobe, LeBron. But, you know, you can play good defense, they make a shot, all right, cool. But to chase a man around the whole court and then have to fight through two and three picks, that's the hardest thing. Yeah,
that's when they had the big screeners, too. You had to run through Ben Wallace, Rasheed in Detroit. KG was setting picks for Ray, like – chasing them dudes in Indiana. See, it was funny because we were playing Boston in the Eastern Finals, and I had to chase Ray's ass around. I was going between Paul and Ray, and I just couldn't get it. So I called Reggie Miller. I was just like, yo, what the fuck can I do to tell? So he had told me a couple tricks on grabbing and not letting them feel his body, and it helped. But overall, I remember having to chase these dudes around picks. You work your ass off, get hit with big screens, and they still make the shot. That shit used to be so frustrating, man.
It is, so frustrating. It is. That's the hardest thing.
Who was your favorite one-on-one battle?
My favorite one-on-one battle. Man, I had some good battles with Brandon Roy.
Beat Roy.
Hell yeah. Killer.
Playing against Bron in Cleveland a few times. We used to have some good battles. Mm-hmm. Kobe, I remember going back and forth with Kobe one time. Lakers came to Atlanta. Man, probably by like the last 14 points, 15 points, it was just me and him going back and forth. And you know, and when Lakers come to Atlanta, you'll see a number of Laker fans in there.
Yeah.
And, man, they was going crazy. But those are definitely moments that I remember.
You mentioned Brandon Roy as one of your favorite matchups. What made him so special? I feel like he's someone who gets lost in the mix and probably one of the greatest what if stories in the history of the game. What made Brandon Roy so special, in your opinion?
He just knew how to play, man. He had a great pace. He had a great pace to his game, and he was an underrated defender. I thought he was a pretty good defender, and he really made me lock in when I played against him. That's why I say he was one of the good matchups, because he was a quiet guy also, but he got it done.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I thought you guys had some similarities from a, you know, pace of play and never hurried, can play at different speeds if wanted, and can definitely get a bucket. So that's interesting you brought that up as a matchup, because I definitely see some comparisons and some similarities between you two.
Yeah, and he was athletic too. That boy had some sneaky hops.
Hell yeah, dunk on you too.